He's a corporate lawyer at Bose & Mortimer with offices in LA and San Francisco. Like he told you. But his real name is Michael Siegel. And he's based here in LA. He's been married to a woman named Claire for 8 years, and they have a daughter, Anna. He travels to San Fran a couple times a month.
Except when he doesn't.
Except when he doesn't.
He was always just in town for a day or two, but nothing felt wrong until a couple of months ago.
Hey. Just try not to be too hard on yourself. It's people like Michael, the ones who operate the longest, they are dedicated, disciplined. They don't compromise.
Well, I can't believe you got all those photos. You must have really followed him all day. Really?
I had to start where you guys were out. And they're inside. Dinner, a Lakers game, and fucking within 5 hours or so. Yeah, at least he's efficient. Color stuff's in the notebook. Bits in the game, bar, etc. It was a bit of a long night, but that's the job. After you said goodbye, I followed him to work. I stayed in his car until he left for his home.
I don't know how you do this for a living, Ed.
Well, I guess to be fair, me and Mike have one thing in common.
What's that?
I won't compromise either. She will kick herself for not spotting anything sooner, but overall, she took it pretty well. Definitely glad to know the truth. There's more details in the notebook. For reference. Let's see. What else? Oh, yeah, we got a consult tomorrow night at 8. Still fuzzy on the specifics, but they sounded high-end. Oh, and Kristen wanted to meet over coffee, so I brought back Jax. Figured to save us a trip.
Freelance investigation, surveillance, all-night stakeouts. It's a line of work that attracts a certain type of person. It's the kind that prides himself on structure, sacrifice, keeping secrets. My life is a bit complicated. It's just not for the reasons you might think. Eric and Dylan, Ed, everyone else.
Color stuff's in the notebook. It's in the game, bar, etc.
The doctors never really figured out how it happened or why. But we've been living with this condition our whole lives. This condition where only one of us can be awake at a time. We don't have to split things up 6 to 6, but we find it's cleaner. And it keeps things fair. I take nights. Eric takes days. We're sharing a life, for all intents and purposes. So, we have to tell each other everything.
Color stuff's in the notebook. Bits in the game, bar, etc. I hate to sound like a broken record, but we need to talk about that other thing, too. I need to make it work with her, Eric.
But no matter how hard Eric wants us to be, we're not the same person. I'd be lying if I didn't say we have a good thing going. We make a lot of money, we have a fantastic reputation. But that comes with trade-offs.
I don't know what you expect me to say. Nothing's changed. Relationships aren't practical. I'm sure as hell not about to give up hours out of my day so you can screw around with some girl who's just gonna leave you like all the others. You need to seriously focus here, Dylan. Your Michael Siegel notes are sloppy and vague. So look at my red lines and get your shit together. I'm tired of amateur hour. You're better than that. We're better than that. Stop letting this girl cloud things.
Except, this isn't really a partnership. We're not sharing a life. I'm just living half of his.
So it's not getting any better?
I don't see how it could. All he cares about is work.
That's not gonna change.
I once read that dolphins don't really need to sleep.
Dolphins?
Yeah, dolphins.
Right.
So, here's what I suggest you do.
Yes, please.
You dial one up on the telephone. Yeah. And yeah. you just ask them what their secrets are.
Okay, well, I happen to have quite a few dolphins on speed dial.
Yeah, and they've told me numerous times through clicks and whistles that, they don't sleep because they drink massive amounts of coffee.
That's unbelievable.
Yeah, I know, through the blowhole.
Do not just say that. Okay, well, coffee. I could probably get you 2 refills.
Yeah, 2.
Possibly 3.
Okay.
If you're really nice to
me. Nice.
If you're really nice to me.
What kind of nice?
You know what I mean.
I think I do.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you mean.
No.
Huh? No, I think you mean. How nice.
I hate this so much.
Stop it. I'm sorry. I don't know what overtook me. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's almost 4. I should go. I'll see you tonight, though, yeah?
Okay.
What? What?
I'm just so tired. I feel so tired.
Uh-huh. You know, it's not gonna be like this forever.
Okay.
You know that, right?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
It's not. It's not.
You're doing this for 6 months. And you keep saying that. Like you're gonna wake up one night and find out that everything's different and that you're free of whatever it is that you two have. And you and I can be together. You know, actually be together. Instead of whatever this is, which is some secret middle of the night thing where I feel like I should be asking you to leave money on the nightstand.
Dorothy.
Well, it's true, Dylan. It doesn't feel very good. And it doesn't seem like it's just gonna change.
Do you not want to do this anymore? I love you. You know it.
I think you have to make a choice.
You don't know what you're asking.
It's okay if it's him and not me. I mean, he's your brother. I understand. But you've got to figure something out, because I'm not sure how much longer I can keep doing this. What's wrong?
Can we talk?
Yeah, we can talk. Wait, what time is it?
I would love a glass of water.
Okay. Can you please tell me what's going on? You piece of shit.
Hey, you fell asleep early last night around 4, so I figured I'd give you the extra 2 hours now. Don't forget, you've got the consult with Richard at 8. And, I dropped the recorder today. This damn thing just slipped out of my hand. So. Anyway, I will pick a new one up tomorrow.
I love her, even after everything, and I always will, as crazy as that sounds.
It's totally understandable.
She's out late, she never lets her phone out of her sight. There's always a reason, something at work. I'm not an idiot. I know that if I hire you, and I'm right, that's pretty much it. And what's the point of staying with someone if it's not real? 5 years. can I trust anybody if I can't trust her?
The only people you can depend on are your family. Not girlfriends, not spouses. I mean, your parents, your siblings, real family. As everyone else. I will get started on this in the morning. In the meantime, you just try to hang in there, yeah? You'll be okay. I promise.
Thank you.